Has the news of those who came before them not reached them, the people of Nu and Ad and Thamud, and the people of Ibrahim and the inhabitants of Madian and the overturned cities? Their messengers brought them the clear signs. God did not wrong them, rather they wronged themselves. The Great Pyramid, Egypt, 2600 BC. Stonehenge, England, 2000 BC. Angkor Wat, Cambodia, 1150 AD. Machu Picchu, Peru, 1470 AD. What you are seeing are the imposing remains of some old civilizations. Throughout world history, a great many very different civilizations have grown up, ruled for a while, and then faded away when their time came. The level of craftsmanship reached by some of them is enough to amaze us even today. Yet these civilizations, which may have approached and perhaps even surpassed today's levels of mathematical, astronomical, medical, and architectural knowledge, no longer exist. The knowledge they had, the unbelievable riches they acquired, their magnificent palaces and temples now stand empty and in ruins. Despite all their power and wealth, they disappeared off the face of the earth. We now know that some of them were destroyed as the result of terrible disasters. In this film, we shall be examining just what happened to them. We shall also see how these destructive events were actually divine retribution, news of which is given in the Quran. We shall see that the peoples in question were destroyed because of their rebellion against God and their excesses. And archaeological discoveries provide the evidence for this. The people of Lut denied the warnings. We unleashed a sudden squall of stones against all of them. The land of Anatolia, the plains of Mesopotamia, the Arabian Peninsula, and the continent of Africa have witnessed the births of different civilizations since the beginning of time. God sent messengers to them throughout history and call them to his path. Those people who refused to believe the messengers sent to them, who tried to kill or exile them, were all destroyed. One of these civilizations was found within the borders of the present-day state of Israel. This people who settled by the shores of the Dead Sea were the people of Lut. According to the Quran, homosexuality was so rife among these people to whom the prophet Lut had been sent that its like had never been seen before. When their brother Lut said to them, "Will you not do your duty? I am a faithful messenger to you, so heed God and obey me. I do not ask you for any wage for it. My wage is the responsibility of no one but the Lord of all the worlds. Of all beings, do you lie with males, leaving the wives God has created for you? You are a people who have overstepped the limits." When Lut told them to renounce their perversions and brought them God's commands, they denied him, rejected that he was a prophet, and continued with their perverted ways. In return for that behavior, they were destroyed in a terrible catastrophe. Let us now have a look at the archaeological evidence that has recently been unearthed regarding this people that are discussed in the Quran. When we look at the Old Testament, the holy book of both Christians and Jews, we see that the matter is described in the same terms as in the Quran. According to the Old Testament, the city where this deviant people lived was Sodom. Archaeological discoveries from excavations reveal that the city was built near the Dead Sea, which runs along the Israel-Jordanian border. Archaeologists working in the area unearthed evidence of a terrible disaster here. The terrible damage to the human skeletons unearthed bore the signs of a powerful earthquake. According to the Quran, angels came to Lut and gave him this warning the night before the disaster. They said, "Lut, we are messengers from your Lord. They will not be able to get at you. Set out with your family, except for your wife, in the middle of the night, and none of you should look back. What strikes them will strike her as well. Their promised appointment is the morning. Is the morning not close at hand? When our command came, we turned their cities upside down and rained down on them stones of hard-baked clay, piled on top of one another in layers, each one earmarked by your Lord, and they are never far from the wrongdoers." The expression, "turning their cities upside down," in all probability refers to the region being shattered in a powerful earthquake. According to a news story carried by the BBC under the title, "Scientists Uncover Sodom's Fiery End," the British geologist Graham Harris was one of the scientists to discover powerful evidence on the subject. According to Dr. Harris, Sodom had been built on the shores of the Dead Sea and traded in the asphalt found in the region. This tarry substance was used in ancient times to waterproof boats and to hold stones together in buildings. Yet this settlement area, right by the Dead Sea, also stood on very unstable land. This was the point where two tectonic plates moving in opposite directions met. This was an earthquake zone. The layers of lava and basalt unearthed during the excavations are the strongest proof that there had been a volcanic eruption, an earthquake here. The event described in the Quran in the words, "Rain down on them stones of hard-baked clay," was in all probability a volcanic eruption. The event described in the same verse in the words, "When our command came, we turned their cities upside down," may well refer to the ruptures and destruction caused by the earthquake. Under the Dead Sea shores lie large deposits of flammable methane pockets. The earthquake would have set these in motion and ignited them. The ground would have turned into a quicksand, and a massive landslide would have swept the city into the water. A series of scientific experiments at Cambridge University confirmed this theory. Scientists built a replica of the region in which the people of Lut had settled in the laboratory and induced an artificial earthquake. As had been expected, the earth was inundated and the miniature houses slid into it and were buried there. These archaeological and experimental discoveries reveal one important fact. The people of Lut discussed in the Quran really lived in the past and were punished for their perversions by a disaster sent by God. The evidence for that disaster has today been revealed and is in complete agreement with the account given in the Quran. Once again, the fact is revealed that the Quran is the word of God. So the great blast seized hold of them at the break of day. We turned the place completely upside down and rained down on them stones of hard-baked clay. There are certainly signs in that for the discerning. Mount Vesuvius is a symbol of Italy, and especially of the city of Naples. The volcano is also known as the Mountain of Misfortune. There is a good reason for this. A city built on its slopes experienced a similar catastrophe to that which hit the city of Sodom. The name of the city, destroyed on account of its rebellion against God and its perversions, was Pompeii. These pictures portray what was once the busiest street in Pompeii. The city was a holiday destination of the high society of the Roman Empire and a symbol of wealth. The architecture of the houses was breathtaking. The people of Pompeii were very wealthy. Yet, instead of giving thanks to God for that wealth, they turned into a nation of deviants and gave themselves over to debauchery, and the city became a den of iniquity. Pompeii was best known for two things. One was the gladiatorial combats organized in the huge arena solely for the amusement of the rich. That savage spectacle had only one rule: to fight to the death. The second largest arena in the empire, after the Colosseum in Rome, was that of Pompeii. In the early years of Christianity, that arena witnessed the deaths of countless numbers of people, solely because of their belief in God. This unbelievable savagery came to be the greatest form of entertainment for the people of Pompeii, whose consciences had withered and died. The second main feature of Pompeii was that it was the scene of the most ruthless implementation of the system of slavery, which prevailed throughout the Roman Empire. For a slave to disobey an order, there could be only one end. They were treated as worthless objects, bought for money. Yet the real oppression of the slaves by the nobles of Pompeii was something different. They were forced into prostitution. The perverted homosexual relations between themselves among the nobles ended in the rape of slaves no older than children. In short, their wealth had made the people of Pompeii degenerate and led them into a morass of perversion and deviancy. They had no idea what was about to happen. Disaster was so terrible that this huge marble bathtub from one of the baths smashed into the opposite wall with unbelievable force, leaving a huge deep scar. In an instant, the lava from Vesuvius wiped Pompeii off the face of the earth. That disaster remained concealed under the ground for the next 2,000 years.